in that in Beijing, I wasn't able to defend my title. Obviously, I had a few injuries going into those games, but I felt okay at least to try and make it go at making the semi or the final. But I got the news the morning of the first round that my grandmother passed away, and that kind of really affected me. I cried the whole day. I mean, I was on the fence of whether I was actually going to run or not. I ran terribly, but I made a promise after that day I was going to win a medal for her before I retired. But it took me 4 years. I've made finals. Last year I came close. I got fourth. But coming into this games, I brought a picture of her. I pinned it under my bed, and I wrote what I called it, obviously, abuela, on my spikes, which is grandmother in Spanish. And I ran with all my heart. I mean, I was really emotional all week, and just thinking about her, thinking about if I could win a medal, just all those things. I mean, all of us do it. I mean, you think about winning, because you train so hard, and you get to this moment, and everything has to go right for you actually to pull it off. In 14 years at a high level, first world championships in 1999. And you just think back of all the years, how fast this went, all the hurdlers I've seen come and go, and I'm still here. I've made six straight finals and at world championships, and getting on the podium and actually winning another Olympics. And I didn't even care what the time was, and then find out the time was the same time I ran in Athens, which is almost impossible to do. But it's just amazing feeling. When I got on the podium, I was just full of emotion, and ironically it started raining, and it just made me feel like my grandmother was crying tears of joy. She was proud of me. So that's what brought the tears.